Hello, my name is Daniel. In this video, you will learn how to add a new reapon to the project and modify it. First of all, we need to add a new reapon. Even if it is a static mesh, we need to import this asset as a skeletal mesh. You can use our M-plane base material as a base for your reapon material instance. You also need to have a clip as a separate mesh. Now you need to set up required sockets of the mesh. Open the skeleton of your mesh and add muzzle, shells, and clip sockets. In the clip socket, add your clip mesh as a preview object to set this socket in the right position. You can also change the type or the physics asset of your weapon if you want. Now we need to add this weapon to the data table. In this data table, you can duplicate the existing row of the weapon. You can modify the scatter of the weapon, its damage, max ammo in the clip, bullets per burst or shotgun shot. You can add different types of fire modes and set aim settings to the weapon. The icon is used in the kill lock. You can also set if your weapon can wiggle or not. Next thing is to set up weapon animations. I will use animations from the rifle too, so they can look not very accurate with this weapon. I have already prepared animations, we just need to set them in the data table and set up anim montages for some of them. But before all of this, we want to be able to connect the VAPN to the hands. We need to create socket for our VAPN in the player skeleton. After this, we need to open items data table and duplicate the existing VAPN row. Here we need to change the name VAPN data table and the hand socket. We also need to set here an actor that will be connected to our hands and the actor that we will be able to interact with in the world. In these actors, we can use any visual modifications, meshes or particles. These actors you need to initialize in the items data table. Let's add a VAPEN clip and reload to the VAPEN. In the VAPEN data table, we need to say the name of our clip socket in the hand. This socket we need to add to our skeleton. We need to make an in-montage out of our reload animation and add montage notifies with the names like in the video. The same thing we need to do with the grenade animations. you need to create holster and roll animation montages. You need to add here a montage notify too. The name doesn't matter. The notify is an event when you remove weapon in holster or take weapon in draw. The most important thing in animontages is a blend time. If your notify is in the blend time range, this notify will not fire. That's why you need to make blend time smaller and make sure your notify is out of the range of blend. Blend in is in the start of animation and blend out is in the end of animation. You can add a new type of the weapon if you want to have different behavior for it. I will tell you about this later in the next timecode. Let's add a new Emma. First of all, we need to add a new type in the enumeration. This type we can set in the weapon data table to any weapon. Now we need to add an Emma slot in the Emma data table. Here we need to initialize our new type and the mesh. We also need to initialize this ammo in the items data table to be able to store and pick up this ammo. Now we can create an interactable object and initialize it with our new row from the data table. We also can add Emma to our character by default. For the new type of the weapon that we added before into enumeration, we need to make some modifications in the weapon component. First of all, we need to set up two functions. You need to modify them if you want your weapon to be an automate. We can also add a new type of the fire mod that we can also add to any weapon in the weapon data table. This type we need to set up in the weapon component. We can write any logic here for the new mod and call it in the switch event. Now you can equip the new type of the weapon using any key through the holster component. If you don't want to have minimaps on your VAPN, you need to turn them off in the image settings.